So the majority of my freelance video gigs that I get are talking head interviews for corporate clients, businesses, things like that. And my dream setup has always been a two-camera setup. I've mostly gotten away with just one, my Fuji X-T3, which is filming me right here. But as soon as Fuji announced the GFX 100, I was very interested in its video capabilities. Granted, the original GFX 100 did not really have great video capabilities. It could do really high-end video content, but people said it wasn't that efficient as a video camera. However, when the GFX 100S was announced, pretty much that thing was an all-in-one beast powerhouse camera. Not only that, it switched to a phase detect autofocus instead of a contrast-based autofocus. And it was honestly the first camera that Fuji reps said you could probably use as a video camera and be very comfortable with it. So ever since the GFX 100S came out, I've been so excited to get my hands on one to see if I could do a two-camera setup with my Fuji X-T3 and then the GFX 100S as my B-cam, providing a close-up tight shot to create just a crazy shallow depth of field. Because if there's one thing that nobody is doing right now, like everybody's in full frame, everybody's on the Red, Komodo, things like that, you know, Sony FX6, FX3. One thing nobody is doing is medium format video. And that's where I feel the GFX 100S provides an advantage as a professional. I think I can offer something that nobody else can if I had the GFX 100S. However, it's very hard to get. I haven't really had a chance to really test it out. That being said, I have one right now and it's shooting me right there. Hi. Hopefully it's doing a good job. I've got it set up on my Rhino Arc slider, doing a controlled move. This is my ideal setup for talking head interviews and just kind of, you know, corporate B-roll type stuff. This is kind of what I want. And also with the Rhino Arc, it's a second shooter. I don't have to worry about controlling it. I can just set it up and go. So whenever I have someone that I'm interviewing, I can just set it and forget it. But what I'm really interested in is how well the GFX 100S does on the face detect autofocus, which I'm not really expecting it to do well. I should also mention the lens that I am pairing it with is the 120mm f4, which I think equates out to around a 90 or 100mm like f2.8. It's essentially their 100mm macro full frame equivalent. And so the focus should be pretty razor thin. But not only that, I'm just curious to see what medium format video looks like compared to a APS-C format. I'm on my 16-55 f2.8 right here. That is the 120 f4. And hopefully the face tracking is working really well. I know the Fujis are known to focus hunt. I know that the medium format ones are not known for their great continuous autofocus, especially in video, but I'm gonna test it out, see how it goes. This is in my apartment. I got a lot of nice natural light going in here. I don't have any lights going right now. I've just got my Zoom F2 recording me right here. So pretty much I am just kind of focused on seeing how this looks. And also, can I match it? I'm shooting in F-log on both cameras. So in theory, I should be able to match, but they are two completely different sensors, two totally different beasts. You know, you got the 26 megapixel X-Trans 4 in the X-T3, and then you got this amazing GFX sensor, this 100 megapixel sensor, which, fun fact, of the sensors on the market that record video, it is the only sensor larger than the GFX 100S is the Arri Alexa LF, which is, I don't know how many tens of thousands of dollars of a camera. It's the GFX 100S has a sensor bigger than the Red Monstro, bigger than Canon's C500. It's literally the second largest sensor on the market, and it shoots, not only can it shoot 10-bit internally in a log format, if you hook it up to an Atomos, it'll do 12-bit ProRes RAW. So it is a raw, 12-bit raw cinema camera, in my opinion, maybe one of the best, and it only costs $6,000 brand new. This right now is just my dream setup. Obviously, my X-T3, do I wish I had an X-T4? Sure I do. I wish I had the IBIS and the flip-out screens, because let me tell you what, no flip-out screens on either of these cameras sucks. trying to set this up by myself. I had to record, test it, review, adjust, record, test, review, adjust. For all I know right now, I'm not even framed up properly. So it could be really bad. So I am just hoping that I don't have to do this whole thing over again. But yeah, this whole thing is just a test to see if, like, how it looks. Like, is it worth having a medium format camera for video? Granted, I want it just in general because I also do a lot of photography for interiors. So having high megapixels is very, very important. I know, like, if you're not doing anything that requires a high megapixel count, I'll tell you to go for like a 20 megapixel camera all day. Canon R6 over the R5, you know, the Z6 over the Z7, that kind of stuff. But I don't know, man. Something about medium format video gives you a look that nobody else can give you. Like, literally, who else? Like, until DJI releases their, like, Hasselblad follow-up to the X1D, which God knows what that's going to have. Is that going to have the LiDAR detect in it? That would be friggin' nuts. But on the only camera on the market right now that is doing what is larger than full frame is the GFX 100S. And the GFX 100 to a degree, but it's not as efficient as this guy. Or as accessible at $10,000. So, yeah, I'm just really fingers crossed that this setup is going to work out. So, let's have a look-see. Okay, round two. After reviewing the footage, one, I was not in frame properly. Hopefully my X-T3 frame is good. Hopefully my GFX 100S is better. I was definitely more this side of the frame. Hopefully it's a lot better now. Like I said, it's very difficult to test when you do not have a flip-out screen. All you people saying you don't need one, screw you, you need one. It's incredibly important. So especially for video shooters, like, I don't want video shoot. Like, just shut up. We all need one. We can only be so lucky if we have Panasonic's version. So after reviewing the footage, I decided to make some adjustments. But also, the face detect autofocus on the GFX 100S, not great. Granted, I am using one of their earlier lenses. So it's also a tank. This 120 millimeter lens, it sounds like a 70s computer when it's like autofocus. It's very mechanical, very like robotic sounding, and it's very loud. So I really don't know that the autofocus on it is that great. Perhaps the new kit lens that they've paired with the 50S Mark II is much better. I've actually used it in person at the camera store that I work at. It's surprisingly snappy. So that being said, I decided to sort of try and guess where I would be sitting using my case right over here. Hopefully I manually focus and is now set to be at this focus all the time. The only concern is my focal plane is diagonal over here, so I might be going out of focus at certain points on the track. It sucks. Not having a focus puller. That being said, this whole setup is kind of my dream. I am really wanting to get my hands on GFX 100S. Hopefully this looks a lot better. I'm also going to throw a few different LUTs if I can on this. I tend to stick with the Eternal LUT. I mean, why would you not? It just looks so good. Just throw it on there and boost the contrast a little bit. You got something looking really nice. I also opted not to use extra lights for fill or anything like that. Granted, it's pretty bright in here anyways. With the natural light coming in, it is a gloomy day, but I'm actually hoping that works out. I kind of want it to be a little darker on this side because I'm curious to see how they both work in unison. As far as like boosting the shadows, if I have to see how noisy it is. The GFX 100S is set to 800 ISO. I believe that's the lowest, that's its native ISO for F-log on that camera, whereas the X-T3 is set to 640. Also, we are shooting in 10-bit H.265, 420, not 422. So hopefully we'll be able to get some more detail out of these images. And yeah, let's go to the editing bay.